Hello. We are going to do another index card today. And to start with, I'm going to kind of loosely sketch out the picture that I want to do. I'm going to have a tree over here on this side, kind of like just part of the tree. And just have it go up. And then I'm going to have, let's see. Sorry, I'm not very chatty right here. I'm thinking. Okay. Okay, so basically we're going to have a tree and some grass and sky. And I think I'll go ahead and I'm going to use some distress paint like I've done before. You've seen me use these for the grass and for the sky. And just put a little on here and then I'll spread it out with a damp brush. Okay. I need a paper towel here. All right, now I'm going to do the same thing with the blue color, but I'm going to put some off onto the craft mat here because I'm going to have to go around these branches a little bit. Be difficult to use the that sponge dauber in between all these branches. So we'll just use a little brush. Spread this out just a little bit, thin it out a little. I don't want it to be too dark. Well, more like sky if it's a little lighter. Got another thunderstorm coming up. We already had one today. So, of course, you know, right when I decide to sit down and film, here comes another one with the thunder and all the noise. And it'll probably get dark. And anyway, I'm trying to get finished with this, get this filmed for you before it gets dark and too noisy. I know this looks a little messy right now, but it'll look better, of course, once I get the branches and the tree branches put in there. Some leaves on the tree and okay. All right, I'm going to take a baby wipe and just see if I can take a little of that green away. It may be too dry already, but I'm going to see what happens here. Oh, it's coming off. It's just a little bit heavy. Okay, I like that a little bit better. We're just going to dry this just a little bit so we can keep going. Okay. So I'm going to use my Faber Castell Pitt Pens to color in the tree. I like using these pens for the tree, especially because it it makes marks like tree bark as it dries, and as you add more more of the marker, it begins to look like kind of like a real tree. So I think that's pretty cool. And then rather than keeping the lines straight and even, I try to put little bumps and things here and there like a tree would have. It would have uneven edges and bumpy areas where bark and knots and things like that are on the tree. So that's the reason I'm kind of going back and adding some of those. Make a knot hole looking area. Kind of cool. All right. I'm going to add a little bit of texture on the grass. I'll do that with the sponge like I've done before. just use a tiny bit of paint. This is apple barrel palm leaf. I might have to use a different shade. Let's see how dark this one is first. It looks pretty good. I'll wipe away a little of this one. This area there. Okay. Some little pieces of my sponge are kind of coming off here on the thing. That's why I'm blowing it. Okay. Gives a little more texture to the grass. Up a little bit. Okay, and put just a little bit of shadow with another Faber Castell pen, a black this time, and just put a little shadow in here. That knot hole kind of area. To look a little bit more realistic. And I'm going to go over these areas. There's some areas here where I drew over the green that are kind of obvious, so I need to fill those in just a little bit darker with the brown. The next thing I'm going to do is add some leaves to the tree. I'm hoping this is going to work well because I do have the blue there on the background, so I hope we'll still be able to see the leaves well. Just using a couple of different shades, a lighter shade and a couple of darker shades. Just to give it some shadow and light. And what I'm going to do is just take my finger and just dip it in a couple of these. It'll mix a little bit, but I just want to just add a little leafiness areas in the tree here. Put a little dark in there also. So it's not really going to look like individual leaves, but more like a mass of leaves. coming from these large branches here. Here. So you get the idea that there's big leafy areas on the tree. Okay. Now, since I have so much green left over on the mat here, I'm just gonna take a new index card and just pick up some of that on the card, see? We may end up using that for one here coming up soon. You don't know. Okay. Also want to add a little bit of definition to this line, this grass line back here, horizon. Now the fun part here is I want to put a swing hanging from this tree branch. So what I did was I took a cup cover, cup holder, cup, whatever you call it, so you can hold the cup at Starbucks. And I just cut a little section out of it right here to use for the seat of the swing. And then I had this tiny twine. It's very tiny. It's not the size of your normal twine. So I'm going to take that and, you know, use that for the ropes on either side of the swing. This is going to be like an old-fashioned type swing. Not with chains or anything, but just like a rope swing. So first, I think I want to just dress the edges of the swing seat just to give it a little bit of a shadow and texture. Using distress Distress Ink Vintage Photo. Just to go around the edge a little bit, and maybe in the center just to age it. We want it to look old, like it's been hanging there a while. Okay. All right. I'm not sure how long I want to make these. So let's see. Okay, I'm gonna say about there. I have two of these. I've already knotted it at the top so that I can just glue it and attach it to the tree. And then I'm just going to bring this down to the sides of the swing. I'm also going to have a little knot, which I've already made here, just a tiny little knot. And that's going to come out of the bottom edge of the swing. So I think I'm just going to turn it over and just go ahead and glue these to the bottom of the swing. Open up my glue here. Okay, so let's see, probably right around here. Then we'll do the same thing on the other side. So now we're just gonna, this twine stuff has all those little hairy pieces sticking out, constantly having to trim those. So we just put a little glue on each side. And then I'm just setting the little ropes in. Going to make a mark with the pen here to signify the little darkened area where that's a hole that the rope is going down into the swing seat. Just adding some glue now to the tree branch. Okay, so we have a swing. And then the last thing I want to add is a little fence down here at the bottom. And I made this with toothpicks. I cut some toothpicks in half. And I took a wire. This is a very thin wire. And what I did was I took this out of a ribbon. You know how you can get ribbons that are wired? And there have been occasions when I didn't want wire in the ribbon. And so I would just slide it out of the edge of the ribbon, and I just saved them, not knowing if I would ever use them, but it seemed like a good thing to have. And so in this case, it worked out to be a really good thing. So all I did was hold the wire, took a piece of the toothpick, and I'll lay it in place and just wrap it once or twice. Just like that. So I just want it to look like an old fence. This piece fell out. Okay. And I just wanted to have that running along the bottom. Along the bottom here. Like that. Be a challenge to get that to stick down, but we're going to give it a shot. If my toothpicks would stop falling out, it would be a lot easier. Okay. It doesn't want to stay in there. I think I'm going to put a little glue on the wire here and slide the toothpick back up in there and see if it'll stay. Oh, of course not. It all came off on the top of the toothpick. There we go. All right, I'm going to try it. I'm going to just put a little glue on the back sides. Actually wanted it to be on this side, but I don't know if I can turn it over. I'm sorry, I'm out of frame. Let me slide it up a little bit. These are very fiddly. All right. Let's see if we can get it. I think I'm going to have it off to the side just a little. Probably a little bit lower. I have to trim off the bottom edge. can get some more glue in there. I may need another toothpick to add some glue. Okay, so the glue is not quite dry, but it's dry enough that it's holding it in place. I went ahead and trimmed off the bottom, and I'm using just little wire cutters to snip the ends of the fence post or toothpicks even with the bottom edge of the card. And then I'm just going to take scissors and cut the wire. There. Like that. So that's what I wanted to do today. Just a simple little picture of a swing in a tree with a little fence. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I hope you'll give it a try. It's pretty fun. And you can see it's easy if you just kind of map it out first with a pencil, and then you can erase and make any changes that you want to make, you know, while you have a pencil eraser, and then just color it with markers or paints and crayons. Anything would work. And just use simple things around the house, like the coffee, the Starbucks thing that goes on the cup. So anyway, I hope you'll give it a try, and come back and join me again. Thanks, everyone. Bye.